guys, in this video, I'm going to be talking about 5 tips and tricks that you can start doing right now to help you be a better line cook. If you haven't subscribed already, hit the subscribe button. I'm going to be putting out more of these tips and tricks videos per your request. Hit the like button, turn on notifications, and hopefully you'll get something out of this. These are in no particular order. I just picked 5, so let's go. The first thing I notice among a lot of the messages that I get with you guys is you guys seem to worry a lot about the age gap. Some of you guys are very young, starting very young. I completely understand. No matter how old you are, when you go into the kitchen, be respectful, be ready to learn. A good kitchen, a good chef, and a good team will help the new guy out. A good team, a good environment is not gonna stress you out more than you need to. This job's already stressful enough, coming in with orders, coming in with mods, refire, it's already crazy. You need to be in a kitchen that's gonna be patient, but know how to push you. Pretty simple. Don't worry about your age. Speed comes with experience, and experience only comes with time. You just got to do it over and over and over. Me as a lead line cook, I do my very best to instruct them in a way that they can understand. It's not whether I can understand it. I can understand it well. I've been doing this, you know, the same dish over and over and over. Can I explain it to the next guy? I always feel that you really don't know a dish, you really don't know how to do a task if you can't explain it well. So if you're on the giving end, if you're training someone new, learn how to communicate with people. Everyone communicates differently and everybody learns differently. There's not one shoe fits all for everyone. Number 2, be early. It helps with unforeseen circumstances, whether it's, you know, like you got a flat tire, or you missed the bus, traffic, all these things. It also helps you show up to work not feeling stressed out. You're not rushing, you're not 5 minutes late and service has already started, and then now you're jumping in, you have to get your stuff ready, and it's just a clusterfuck. Showing up early allows you to come in, assess the situation, figure out, okay, am I jumping in running? Do I have a little time, you know, to set myself up? And just do that. And it feels really good. You know, it feels really good to be able to just set up your station, do what you need to do, and not rush it. And if things are already going crazy, it feels even better to show up and just start helping the guy that's already there and make that smooth transition. You know, maybe you can take over the orders and then this guy can start setting up your station for service. Number 3 is be focused. Now, it's pretty simple to say be focused in the task that you're doing, but something that helps me focus is an hour before work, I have an alarm that goes off. It just says get ready for work. Immediately, an hour before my shift starts, I do a shift change in my mentality. I begin to think of the things that I need to start doing for work. If I know that I'm gonna be doing family, I start thinking of ideas, what's in the walk-in, what can I use? It's a little tricky depending on the kitchens you are, especially like I work in a place that specializes in Korean and Jewish food. So that makes it a little interesting when I'm trying to come up with a dish for family meal. I have playlists, I have YouTube videos that just really fire me up. They get me ready. And it's sort of like when you go to the gym, you put on the right playlist that just really gets you going. You gotta find the right thing that gets you fired up. So by the time you walk in that door, let's get it. Number 4, be clean and organized. So anytime I do a project, there's a couple things. Well, to start off personally, what do I have on hand? I always have the towel that hangs off of me. And then I have 2 towels that I have folded up that are on the side. The 2 towels on the side are specifically for grabbing hot things. The 2 towels on my side don't get wet. They're just there to grab hot pans, hot pots, anything that requires me not to be using my bare hands. I always, if I'm working plancha or saute, I always keep a damp towel nearby. And after every order, I always just clean the rail. If I'm in the middle of service and I'm putting out a bunch of tickets, let's say it's a Saturday night, well, if I even have a minute between orders, immediately I'm thinking always, okay, I gotta take out things that I don't need. I gotta organize. I gotta reset. If I'm doing prep work in the afternoon when I start my shift, I always get a cutting board just in case. And then I'll always have like a little quart container or a vein marie where, let's say if I'm picking parsley, I'll have my whole bunch of parsley leaves on a little sheet, on a little sheet tray. And then I'm picking into the quart, and then the stems go into the quart. Again, nothing's really touching the cutting board, but it's there in case I need it, and it's there and it helps keep clean whatever is underneath, whether it's the pass, the line, or the back, whatever surface you're working on. Working clean is absolutely important. Always check, double check after you're done with a project. Make sure you don't have any liquid spilling over onto drawers, under, behind. Wherever you work, that is your station. Own it. And if you're working on someone else in someone else's station, be respectful. You're a guest in that station. Make sure anything you take, you restock. Any messes you make, you clean up. If you see that there's, let's say if you're working next to Saute and he's busting out, a bunch of orders, and you see that maybe he's putting his used saute pans in a corner, help him out. Take those pots back to dish pit. Work clean. Get in the habit of it. Number five, communicate. It's for me, this was really hard to do, especially when you're new. You might not have that confidence to want to speak loud, speak up. I have a voice that naturally carries. Like when I'm getting very excited or I'm talking about something I like, I tend to get louder. What got me to speak loud is my chef noticed that I had a loud voice when I got excited or, was just telling stories. So he would have me be the guy that would call for service. So whenever a dish was ready to go out, I just yell out, "Run, please." And that really helped me. He was okay with me. It's like, "Oh, so I be loud, they need to hear you." And I would do that, and it was a lot of fun. You may not have that situation, but it's so important that you communicate. It's absolutely important. Whether it's give a 2 minutes out, how long for the next dish. If I'm expoing, I'd love to know what you're working on. I'd like to know the next dish you're about to put out. If possible, sometimes it's Saturday service and I'm just letting my chef know, okay, I'm about to give you this, 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 and that in that order. Periodically, I'll give my chef an all day. I have an all day this, this, I got this in the oven. This is working right now. I'm plating items X, Y, and Z. Ask for those all days. It's very important. Again, if you work in a kitchen with an expo, that expo needs to be communicating with you, and you need to be communicating with them, and you need to be communicating with the other cooks. Working in a line, especially in a closed environment, can be described as a dance. Like there has to be synergy, there has to be emotion. If you're going this way, you don't want a guy that comes this way. No, it's like you want a guy that just works around you and you work around them. It's such a beautiful thing when everything's working out great. It's fantastic. And if you're new and you're not sure and you're feeling a little awkward, communicate. I'm behind you. I'm gonna grab the pot. I'm gonna start, let me put a little oil on this pan. I'm gonna get this order started for you. Do you always communicate? I don't think there's such thing as over communication when you're on the line putting out food. Communicate. Okay, so those were the quick. My five tips and tricks for line cooks. I hope you guys found them beneficial. I hope you guys found them informative. I'm gonna be putting out more of these. I have at least six more parts to this video. I'm hoping in time, and if you guys comment, you guys communicate with me and let me know what else you want to do, this line cook tips and tricks can just go on and just become a series. As of now, this is part one of seven. This goes on as long as you want. And just simple practical things that I think will help you in whatever kitchen you work at, whatever caliber it is. I really strongly believe these are things that I've been talking with my mentor, with friends that are cooks and chefs, and I've just been asking them, like, what are some things that you think you would have liked to know when you started off? What are some things you'd like the new guys to know, you know, before they come into the kitchen? So that's what it is, guys. Thanks for watching. Hit the like, sub, bell, you know, all the good shit, man. Share this video with the crew, and I will see you guys in the next video. Take care. Peace. Have a great service, guys.